everybody, it's Sarah. I'm here from Oil Life, and I have Ashley joining me here.
Hi, guys.
And we are here to make a DIY today. So we are so lucky to have Ashley here, and she's going to be joining us more often, yes?
Yes, I'm excited.
And she is the pro of all DIYs. So she's going to help us out, give us all the details, because you know what you're doing. So definitely give her a follow if you don't already. Tell us your username.
Essentially Joyful, but with an oil joyful. And the joy.
Yeah, so give her a follow and you can hear more about, you know, your weekly doings and all that with the oil world.
But yeah, definitely check it out. I'd love to talk to you guys.
Yes, and I'm pretty sure you're going live on your Instagram right now.
I am, so if you're on Essentially Joyful, you'll be able to see this live video as well.
Cool. Okay, so yes, if you're on Instagram, definitely go follow her, see what she's up to, and she'll be here every once in a while to help do DIY with
us. Yes, I'm excited. Thank you.
It's exciting. So today we are going to be making a bath bomb. So I know bath bombs can sometimes be difficult, and you hear, you know, people have problems.
Pinterest fails.
Definitely. It's a struggle, but I will say I have tried out this recipe. I've tried it out today, actually, and we made it work. So if you can see right up here, this is what they're going to look like. They are a little lopsided because, you know, my DIY might not be as good as
okay.
You guys'
it's
DIY.
DIY.
Yes, but we are going to show you how to make this step by step today, and it is actually pretty darn easy. So good news, you'll be able to make it right at home. We are doing a giveaway today, which is awesome. You guys know we do a giveaway every week, and we'll be giving away three different holiday DIY kits. So three winners today. All you need to do is tag a friend that loves essential oils during the holidays. Tag them in this video and let them know that you want them to see what we're making, and you will be entered to win. So we'll be giving away three of these all to different people that tag.
You guys, the DIY books are so awesome.
They are.
Like, perfect. If you haven't done your Christmas shopping yet, you need this.
Yes, I agree. These are awesome. You'll need this, and they're really fun for holiday classes or for just making these great recipes
for yourself.
You know, I'm like, I'm taking one of these home later to do my own bath. And then remember, we also have our holiday lookbook that's out, and this is also a fun one to include in gifts and things like that. So remember, we've got these awesome, awesome things. All you need to do is tag a friend in this video and tell them, you know, you gotta watch this. This is for you. So let's kind of get going. For our bath bomb, we're going to start with some of the basics that you'll use in, you know, all sorts of different recipes. We're going to have our baking soda, our Epsom salts, our mica. You guys, if you saw our gold spray video, we are going to use our gold mica again, which is awesome. You can also use different colors of mica. There's like white and silver and things like that. So whatever color you want to, you know, make your bath bombs, you can use that mica. So we'll kind of do a group effort on this. We're going to do 1 cup of baking soda.
Perfect.
We are going to do 2/3 cups of Epsom salt, so I'll just get started on that. And then we are going to do 1/2 teaspoon of gold mica, or whatever color you want. And then last, we will put in our oils. So for this video, we have in our recipe that we're going to use frankincense. Oh, excuse me, you guys, I'm struggling today. These are going to go right in the blender. It's been a long day.
It's okay.
So, we're going to put these right in the blender. Remember, we're doing 1 cup of baking soda. We're going to do 2/3 cups of Epsom salt. We're going to do 1/2 teaspoon of gold mica. And then we're going to do our oils. So, we chose frankincense and myrrh for this bath bomb because it's kind of fun. It's holiday themed. But you can kind of do whatever you want. So, there are some awesome benefits to using these in your recipes. Tell us a little bit more, why do you like, which is your favorite, frankincense or myrrh? What would you say?
I think frankincense, especially because you can get it for free this month. That's always awesome.
Yes.
But frankincense is kind of the oil that you'd ever want to grab if you don't know what to grab. So your kid bumps their head, or you have a cut, or you're maybe feeling like some anxiety. You can always grab frankincense, put that on your body anywhere, maybe you didn't smell it, and you're going to have the instant therapeutic benefits of that oil.
So I'm going to put 40 drops in here.
This is so cute, you guys, and this gold mica is so pretty.
It's fun.
I'm excited to see how it turns out.
Sparkle. So we had our graphic designer. She had this idea that it might be really fun if you're doing these as a gift. You can just sprinkle some of the gold mica on top.
That's super cute.
So that you can have like kind of a little extra shimmer on there.
Oh yeah.
So then I'm going to do 10 drops of myrrh, and basically it's not going to look like much. So it'll just kind of look clear. And then last of all, we are going to put in our castor oil. So we are using turkey red oil. We recommend that because it prevents having that oil slick left around your bathtub. So,
oh, that's so nice. It's really nice. Bath bombs, actually.
It can be gross because you'll have that residue left.
That residue left over.
Yeah, so this will help prevent that really gross residue. Oh. It'll just wipe right off.
I love that.
Yes. Awesome. So that's why we're using turkey red oil in this recipe. So we are going to have, like we said, we're going to have our baking soda. We are going to have our gold mica. We have our bath salts.
Here, Epsom salt.
Epsom salt, okay. And then we're gonna have our oils in here.
Awesome.
With the turkey red oil, and we are just going to go ahead and blend that. So, gotta make sure my blender's on.
So just a slow blend, it looks like.
Yep.
Okay.
So we're going to do a slow blend, and I have noticed that it does stick to the outside, so if you have some sort of a scraper or anything, just kind of push it down to the sides to make sure it's all mixing together, because this part needs to be mixed really well.
Okay,
and often the oil will stick to the outside, so make sure that's all in, that's all mixed together, and then once you're done, you'll be ready to move it to the big bowl. So I'll just mix this one more time, and then we'll be ready to go.
So I was really thinking that we could do like lavender and eucalyptus and bath bombs. That would be so good for this time of year.
That would smell amazing too.
For the sinuses.
I love the smell of lavender. The bath bombs that I actually made already, I think I might have already said this, but they are lavender because I love the smell of lavender. So I think that would be amazing in a bath. It's kind of relaxing though. Yeah. You guys that are watching, what oils would you put in your bath bombs? Which one would you think would be the most soothing? Would you do a blend? Would you do a single oil? What would you do in your bath bomb?
How many of you are seeing balance right now? I bet it's a lot.
Oh, probably.
Yes. This time of year, you need your balance.
So tell us, what other DIYs have you made lately for the holiday season? Anything fun?
So I just made a cough stick because my son had a cold and I didn't want him to be coughing all night long. Vetiver was amazing in it. And I used your guys' shea butter and cocoa butter. Oh, so good.
Ooh, that sounds amazing.
Yeah, it was really awesome.
And is that on your Instagram?
It is, but it's from like 2 weeks ago. So if you guys are looking on Instagram, go back about 2 weeks and you'll see a cough stick on there.
That sounds incredible. Okay. This is mostly mixed, which means we are ready to put it in our big bowl.
Yeah.
So that's exciting. We recommend a wider bowl so it can kind of spread out. So you'll just dump it in there, and then all you'll need to do is make sure that it's kind of all mixed together if your blender didn't quite do the trick. You can also use a food processor if you have one of those. So
Okay.
It kind of just depends what you have in your kitchen, but lots of different choices. So if there's anything extra, just make sure it's all mixed up, and then there'll be a little clump, a couple clumps because of the oil, but mostly it should be pretty mixed together. And then we are going to add our citric acid. So
perfect.
Got that, and it should be half cup of citric acid. And so we'll mix that right into our big wide bowl.
So with your citric acid, guys, just keep it away from your face and you'll be totally good.
And it's nice, we do sell citric acid here in our store, so you can purchase
that. And I like it too, it's not powdery. Mine that I have is like, it goes everywhere.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
Yeah, it's nice. Other things that we sell at Oil Life that you can buy for this recipe is we do sell witch hazel, which will be next on the list. And then of course, the recipe to make this is in the holiday DIY kit, so definitely get your hands on that. Okay, so it's mostly mixed in, you would say,
perfect.
Right?
Yes.
So the next part is kind of the tough part. What we're going to do is we are going to spray witch hazel over the top, but you don't want to spray too much, otherwise it starts to dissolve.
Yes, exactly.
So basically, I've put it in one of our bigger spray bottles that we sell here, but it is just our regular witch hazel. So we're going to spray it right over the top, just like a thin sheet, and then we're going to mix it together. And basically, how you know if you have enough witch hazel on there is if you grab a handful of it and it sticks together, it like holds its shape.
Okay.
That's how you know.
So you're making a snowball, guys. It's going to stick together.
Exactly. So give it a spray, and then I'm happy to mix when you're done.
Okay.
Perfect. So it's kind of fun. You'll hear it start to sizzle if you go up close because it foams a little bit. And you'll see it'll create more clumps as you go. So we'll do a little more. Perfect. And it has that cute, like, gold color to it. I love it. And it still looks natural. It doesn't have, like, a really fake gold look to it. It's, like, a pretty light gold. So now we can kind of check, is it wet enough? So as we can see, it doesn't quite hold yet, so maybe we'll do a little bit more and then it'll hold that shape. Yes. So I had one of those Pinterest fail moments the other day.
I have had those too.
It was exciting. I put in too much witch hazel and basically they puffed up like they were snowballs.
Like the giant explosions.
Exactly. Yes. So they started to like swell and they overflowed and it got a little bit crazy. So make sure you're not totally overdoing it with the witch hazel because your recipe won't turn out if you put in
way too much. Like just a few sprays.
Just a few sprays should be adequate. So we can try it again. And it pretty much holds together, so maybe like a teeny, teeny bit more. It's kind of nice that you can have that visual way of knowing. You don't just have to
guess. It's in the spray bottle. That's an awesome idea. And guys, great. I love this for my On Guard cleaner. I do everything in my house with that.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. That's a great thing to put in there. And we have them in like a billion different colors, so.
Yes.
If you want to go into Match Your Kitchen, we've got blue, and we've got purple, and lots of cute colors. Okay, it's looking pretty good to me.
Awesome.
So. This is where it starts to get a little bit messy. Make sure you have your sleeves rolled up. What you're going to do is you're going to fill some molds. You can choose fun molds or you can just do circle ones like we have.
Mm-hmm.
And what I recommend doing is filling both halves, you know, a little bit fuller than they need to be, both halves, and then you'll put them together and it'll cement them.
Oh, perfect.
So it's kind of up to you. You can do it the clean way like Ashley, or you can do it the messy way like me. And then you're just going to want to put them together so that they are tight, just like that. So it'll make those circular bath bombs.
And how long do these sit for?
So we recommend you let them dry overnight, 24 hours. But you should be able to tap them right out of your molds almost immediately.
Okay.
So they should be compact enough that you can just open them up. Tap it out, be careful so they don't totally
explode
like
everywhere.
Powder. Don't do a Pinterest fail. But you should be able to tap them out and then let them sit, and they should maintain their shape if you put just enough witch hazel in them. So, kind of fun.
Perfect. These are looking good.
If I move this out of the way a little bit, you guys can see if I open up my bath bomb mold, I can pull it out and it should be in that really pretty shape.
Look at that. It's so perfect.
I know.
And if you put it's dying.
So,
don't die.
As you can see, this is our Pinterest fill, right? We might say, okay, we need more witch hazel, right?
Yeah, maybe a little bit more witch hazel.
Maybe a little bit more witch hazel on this one. We'd put it right back in the bowl. We'd spray some more witch hazel, and then we'll be ready to go.
And this is a super easy DIY. We went in here for like 5 minutes, so you can just keep going.
It's been quick. So, those will be ready to go. They're easy, and when they're done, they will look just like this. This is our exact same recipe. So, they're kind of fun. And they work great. So I pulled out a bowl of water so we can kind of demo and make sure that they work. Which one do you want to choose? So I'll grab the bowl and you can drop them there. So not only do they smell great, they actually work. Drop it in there. Let's see.
Whoa.
I love how they look.
I don't know what I was expecting with that. And look, you guys, you can see the glitter on there. That is so awesome.
I think it's really pretty. And so it kind of makes your bath have a little bit of a mood. Yeah. It smells great. Scrape your skin, and it won't totally stick to your tub because of that turkey red oil. So
this probably makes about, what, 5 bath bombs?
It makes about 4 or 5 bath bombs. Uh-huh. So, like, for example, when I made these, I packed them pretty tight, so I had about 4.5.
Okay.
So if you want, you can have, if you're doing it for a class or something, you could have, like, half of one to demo and show, look, they actually work, just like we did today.
That would be so fun to do with your teens, too, to do a DIY bath bomb class.
It would be.
I'm going to do that.
And I think they're a fun gift too, honestly. Mm-hmm. Like, everyone loves to get a bath bomb. You know that there's a ton of companies that are making these and selling them.
Oh my gosh, for so much.
Tons of money, and you can just make them for yourself with all the ingredients you already have. So.
And you know what's in them. That way you're not worried about chemicals either.
Totally. So it's still foaming, it's still looking good. And that's pretty much all we have for you today. Again, don't let your bath bombs be a bath bomb fail. Make sure you have enough witch hazel on there to make sure that they set and that they make these solid bath bombs just like we have here on our video. So, kind of fun. Thanks for joining us today. Thanks for helping
us
with our DIY. Kind of fun. And make sure that you're tagging your friends for entries for our giveaway today. We are giving out a holiday DIY kit. 3 of them, actually.
So fun, guys.
So fun. So, again, check out Ashley on Instagram. Yes. And that's all we have. We will see you guys on Friday. Thanks.
Okay, Merry Christmas.